Welcome to this mini course on building vision applications with OpenVINO. Vision is everywhere, and the potential of using AI to create automated control and decision systems is huge. An hour from now, you'll be able to build a full AI-based Python application that can basically perform any such task automatically. This is a short series of videos with hands-on exercises, so you can experience and program yourself. The only required knowledge is basic Python programming skills. In the first video, we'll talk about the advantages of using OpenVINO, what's included, and more. In the next video, I'll help you install and get started with the labs. In video number 3, we'll get a deep learning-based model. In the fourth video, we'll look at the simple face detection Python code using OpenVINO, and you'll be able to practice it yourself. In the fifth video, we'll take a look at the solution of the simple face detection application. In video number 6, I'll explain how to add another model to the application, and we'll not only detect the face, but also decide what is the emotion of this person, and you'll have the opportunity to code it yourself. And in the last video, video number 7, we'll review the emotion detection solution and see how to add more models to the application to detect age and gender. It's gonna be fun. Let's begin. Before we even start, this is the video series about building vision applications using OpenVINO. I believe it's a great place to start, but if you are specifically looking for NLP, audio, or other usages, check out my other relevant video series. The full AI pipeline starts with data. Data that has to be cleaned up and arranged, and then there's a long iterative model training process and validation of the results. The end result of this stage is a model that meets our accuracy expectation, and this is a starting point for OpenVINO. You can theoretically use the training frameworks like TensorFlow or PyTorch for inference and deployment, but OpenVINO has so many advantages with very little overhead, so why not? I'll explain the benefits in a minute. There are many ways to use OpenVINO. There are ready-to-use Jupyter notebooks with tons of usages. You can use it in the cloud with no prior installation. You can use it in a Docker container, install using pip and others. I'll do it together in the next video. OpenVINO can run on Windows, Linux, macOS, and many other platforms, and it is open source, so you can always build it to your exotic preferred operating system. You can bring your own model. It doesn't matter where it was trained. We support TensorFlow, PyTorch, and many other formats, and of course, ONNX. If you do not have a model, we'll be happy to supply you with one. The Open Model Zoo has tons of models for any usage you might need. They are free to use in your products, they are highly optimized, and we'll use a few of them soon. We have several optimization utilities that could help you prepare the model for usage. We know how to optimize models in multiple ways and make them smaller and faster. If you'd like to use the models from the Open Model Zoo, but would like to fine-tune them to your specific dataset, we can do that too. OpenVINO code could be written in Python, C++, or C. We have tons of sample code you can use as a reference or as a demo. And the inference engine runtime can take your model and run it efficiently on multiple devices, CPUs, GPUs, FPGAs, and more. When you're ready to build a serving application, we have the ready tools to easily do that. Or you could use Microsoft Azure with OpenVINO integrated as an inference engine. To summarize that, I believe there are 4 main reasons why OpenVINO is so popular. The first reason is simplicity. You can execute inference with just a few lines of code of Python, C, or C++. Yet the API is flexible enough to allow for all the fancy stuff like batching, asynchronous execution, and many other runtime operations. The second is the software portability, the ability to use the same code on the Atom CPU and Xeon servers, on integrated GPUs and Max data center GPUs, and many other devices. The third is performance. OpenVINO depends, of course, on the model, usually runs faster and more memory efficient than the alternatives. Just Google OpenVINO performance, choose your preferred benchmark, choose a platform, and explore the performance results. And the fourth reason is comprehensive. At the heart of OpenVINO, there is an inference engine, but there are code samples, ready-to-use models, many optimized demos, and utility applications. Basically, everything you need in a deployment package. And that's all for this video. You know now what are the benefits of using OpenVINO. Soon, we'll see that in action. Prepare your laptops or your machines. Next video, we will install OpenVINO. See you there.